calculating the standard deviation by step deviation method. So here one problem is there. The time taken by a group of students to solve a problem in mathematics is given in the table below. Calculate standard deviation by using step deviation method. Today we are going to solve this problem by using step deviation method. Problem is like this: class interval 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50. The given frequency 7, 10, 15, 8 and 10. First, write down the table for this to find standard deviation. So you can write the table by using the formulas. If you know the formula of the step deviation method, its standard deviation is equal to square root of sigma fd square by n minus sigma fd by n whole square into c. See which are the terms we need to find. Sigma fd, sigma means summation of fd you should find, and sigma fd square you should find, then n. So here you should all the table should have fd square, fd column and d square d column and d square column and f, all the column should be there. See, they given in the problem class interval and frequency I written here. If you add the frequency, we'll get n, that is if you add all these we'll get 50. X, next come to the term x. X is nothing but middle term. We can find the middle term by using class interval. Add these two, 0 and 10, so you will get 10. 10 is divided by 2, you will get 2 5s. That means x is 5. Similarly, add 10 plus 20 is 30. 30 is divided by 2, you will get 15. See, the difference is 10, we can write remaining. 15 plus 10, 25, then 35, next one is 45. See, next column is D. D is equal to X minus A divided by C. X is the middle term, A is the assumed mean. Assumed mean means you have to take any one as the middle one as a mean. I'll take 25. Assumed mean A is equal to 25. Then C is the common factor of X. In this X, these values are divisible by which table that has taken as common factor. The 5, 15, 25, 35, 45 are divisible by 5. Therefore, the common factor is 5. Then find the value of D. D is equal to X minus A. X is 5 here minus A is 25. So 5 minus 25 whole divided by C is 5. You subtract 25 minus 5 is 20. Minus 20. Minus 20 is divided by 5. You will get 5 4s are 20. You will get minus 4. Similarly, so X is 15 here, 15 minus A is, assumed mean is 25 by 5. 25 minus 5 is 10, minus 10, minus 10 is divided by 5, 5 2s are 10, then minus 2. Then 25, X is 25. Next, the similarly 25 minus 25 by 5, you divide these two, you will get 0. 35 minus 25 is 10. 10 is divided by 5. 5, 2s are 10. Write 2. Then 45 minus 25 is 20. 20 is divided by 5. You will get 4. The next column is d square. Make these values to d square. Minus 4 square is 16. Minus 2 square is 4. 0 square is 0, 2 square is 4, 4 square is 16. Next column is FD. You multiply F column to D column. F is here 7, 7 is multiplied to minus 4. 7 fours are 28. Minus is there, you write minus. Then 10 into minus 2 is minus 20. 15 into 0 is 0. 8 into 2 is 16. Then 10 into 4 is 40. Now, next column is FD square. F column values are multiplied to D square column. So 7 is multiplied to 16. Similarly, 10 is 4, 15 into 0. Like that, we can multiply. So now multiply 7 into 16. 7 into 16 is 112. Then 10 is multiplied to square. 10 into 4 is 40. Then 15 is multiplied to 0. We will get 0. Then 8 is multiplied to 4. 8 fours are 32. Then 10 is multiplied to 16. We will get 160. Next we can find the sum of here in the formula we want sigma FD. Sigma means sum of FD. Sum of FD. You should add all these. See here, these two have minus. Minus 28, minus 20, add these two, will get minus 48. Here see, these two are having plus, add these two, will get 56. Now subtract 48 from 56, you will get, that is, sigma FD is equal to 8. Similarly, find, see, sigma FD square is there. Add all the values of this sigma FD square. That is equal to, if you add all the values of this, you will get 344. Next, substitute all the values to the formula. Standard deviation is equal to square root of sigma FD square by n minus sigma FD by n whole square into C. C is outside the square root. Now we can substitute the values. Square root of sigma FD square. The value of sigma FD square is 344 divided by n is 50. Here number of F is 50, then n is equal to 50 minus sigma FD. The value of sigma FD is 8 by n is 50 whole square into C is common factor is 5. Here is the write down 5. Then divide 344 by 50, you will get 6.88. You divide, so actual division, minus 8 by 50, divide 8 by 50, you will get 0.16, make it a square. See, into 5. Then, square root of 6.88, write as it is, minus 0.16, make it to square. 0.16 into 0.16, you multiply, you'll get 0.03, write 5 as it is. So you subtract 6.88 with 0.03, you will get 6.85 into 5. Now find the square root of 6.85. I'll show how to find square root by division method. 6.85, you already learnt in 9th standard first chapter division of finding the square root by using division method. Here 6 is there. See, 2 2s are 4, you take 3, 3 3s are 9, is more than 6, you take 2, here also 2, 2 2s are 4. Subtract will get 2, same 2 right here and add these 2, will get 4. Next here point is there, you put point here, take 85 as it is. It becomes 285. It will go by 6. You write 6 here, the same 6 you should write here. 6 6 are 36, 6, 3 carry, then 6 4s are 24, 24 plus 3 is 27. You subtract these 2, you will get 9. This is 0 and this is 0. 6 you add, the same 6 you put here and add, will get 552. Here, next you can divide by taking 2 zeros. So every time you can take 2 zeros in division. So here you put 1 and here also 1, will get 521. So this is the square root of this value, equal to this value, nearly equal to this value. This is 2.61 into this 5, right? And multiply, you will get a standard deviation. 5 ones are 5, 5 6 are 30, 0, 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 3, 13. That is 13.05. This is the standard deviation, or you make it to round value, that is 13.1 is the standard deviation. There is no unit for the standard deviation. Thank you.